हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवन फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज़ एपिसोड 87। बैटलग्राउंड्स मोबाइल इंडिया डजंट हैव अ रिलीज डेट येट एंड इंडियन पॉलिटिशियंस आर ऑलरेडी कॉलिंग फॉर इट टू बी बैंड। फॉर्मर यूनियन मिनिस्टर एंड करंट अरुणाचल प्रदेश एमएलए निनोंग इरिंग रोड टू प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी टू रिक्वेस्ट अ बैन ऑन व्हाट ही टर्म्स एज द रीलॉन्च ऑफ पबजी मोबाइल। इन द लेटर इरिंग स्टेट्स दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द क्राफ्ट एंड इंडियन एम्प्लॉयंस आर फ्रॉम टेंसेंट, दैट बैटलग्राउंड्स मोबाइल इंडियाज गूगल प्ले स्टोर पैकेज नेम कंटेन्स द टर्म पबजी मोबाइल एंड सिटीज इट्स $22.4 million इन्वेस्टमेंट इन नॉट बीन एज अ सिक्योरिटी कंसर्न। You can check out this letter for yourself right here. Another politician, Abhishek Shingavi, a member of parliament in Rajya Sabha, took to Twitter to criticize government decision regarding the decision to bring back the PUBG Mobile. The players who are looking forward to Battlegrounds Mobile India will be crushed to note that only are politicians taking a stand against the Battle Royale title. But common people also feel that the Indian government is making a mistake. Another day and here comes another cyber attack incident. This time it is a massive one and has affected many in India as well as globally. Personal data of 45 lakh Air India passengers globally have been leaked in the recent cyber security attack, and this has been confirmed by the airline itself. Hackers reportedly targeted Air India's passenger service system that exposed crucial information such as credit card and passport details among others. This incident was verified by the airline on Friday. In an official statement, the Air India stated that this is to inform that CETA PSS, our data processor of the passenger service system, which is responsible for storing and processing of personal information of the passengers, have recently been subjected to a cyber security attack leading to personal data leak of certain passengers. This incident affected around 45 lakhs data subjects in the world. The cyber security breach involved personal data registered with the airline between August 26, 2011 and February 3, 2021. The exposed data of passengers include name, date of birth, contact information, passport information, ticket information and credit card details. Air India clarified that CVV and CVC data of credit card holders were not stored in the company's database. Bharti Airtel's Chief Executive Officer for India, Gopal Vittal, has said that the company has invested over 38,000 crore in spectrum and network capacity to ensure its customers remain connected during this pandemic. In a letter to the telco's 307.9 million subscribers, Vittal detailed how Airtel is carrying out home delivery of SIM cards and cautioned subscribers against falling prey to cyber frauds. He mentioned that they made an investment of well over 18,000 crore to buy precious spectrum that will dramatically improve indoor coverages in the coming months. We have also invested an additional 20,000 crore to enhance our capacity so that our experience improve even as your consumption rises. India has shot off a letter to Twitter objecting to its manipulated media label on tweets made by political leaders about a document that it claims was created by the Congress to undermine, derail and demean the efforts of the government against COVID-19. Various fact check has been shown that document was created on the forged letterhead. According to the sources, the Ministry of Electronics and IT has told Twitter that it cannot pass judgment on the matter, that it's still under investigation, and has asked the social media firm to remove the label. It said that such content modernization by Twitter put a question mark on its status as an intermediary. Smartphone and electronics makers in India have cut down production significantly, with the sales falling to near zero due to rapid spread of COVID-19 in India, which has led to local lockdowns across the country. Electronics and smartphone are considered as non-essential goods, thereby sales through online channels or e-commerce platforms are not currently allowed. Handsets brand like Oppo, Vivo have completely shut down their factories, while Xiaomi, Samsung and Apple partners have scaled down production in the last few weeks. The report said that Apple partners and Samsung are running their factories at only 25-40% capacity to address global demand. The Consumer Electronics and Appliances Manufacturer Association, representing companies like Samsung and LG among other electronic makers, said company would resume production when markets open. Redmi has confirmed that it will introduce new Redmi Note 10 series 5G smartphone in China on May 26th alongside with the Redmi Book Pro laptops. The company has been posting new teaser images along with posting features of the phone. The company will be introducing several models, including a Dimensity 700 based smartphone that could be Note 10 5G model, and that also reports that the Dimensity 900 processor will debut in Note 10 Pro 5G phone, and the top end smartphone will come up with a Dimensity 1100 processor for Note 10 Pro Plus. wireless. The top-end model will come with a dual-channel UFS 3.1 storage and will support the high frame rate mode of 8 mainstream games that have been tested to run games at constant 90 FPS with minimal frame drop. According to the company, it will also have a VC liquid cooling graphite system with thermal conductivity gel and a copper foil which covered the whole body to achieve the best heat dissipation. The Redmi Note 10 5G is rumored to feature a 90Hz LCD screen with a 48MP main camera and a 18W fast charging as similar to the global version. While the Redmi Note 10 Pro 5G will come with a 120Hz LCD screen and a 64MP main camera which supports 33W fast charging. The top-end Note 10 Pro Plus with a 120Hz OLED screen with 108MP primary camera and supports a 67W fast charging. Xiaomi is gearing up to launch the Redmi Note 10 Ultra 5G in China. The company is working on launching another Redmi smartphone with a 50MP camera. The name of this upcoming Redmi smartphone remains unknown at this moment. However, the camera specifications of the upcoming smartphone have been leaked online. Tipster Abhishek Yadav, citing Digital Chat Station, has shared an image of the device. The image reveals a camera module and its specification. It suggests that the upcoming Redmi smartphone will use a 50MP 1.12-inch GN2 sensor. It is the same sensor found in the Xiaomi Mi 11 Ultra. A couple of days ago, Realme said that it will soon launch a smartphone codenamed Quicksilver powered by freshly announced Snapdragon 778 5G processor. The company didn't reveal the time frame for the same, but now we learned Realme is slated to unveil a Snapdragon 778 powered smartphone on June 18th. The China smartphone market is undergoing changes ever since Huawei was banned by the US. At first, the telecom giant's market share grew due to increased patriotism. However, with no access to crucial suppliers, the company share began to drop gradually. Additionally, in order to survive, it had to sell its sub-brand Honor. Now the market is helmed by Oppo and Vivo, but the fastest growing brand is none other than Realme. The China smartphone market grew 5% in Q1 2021. However, despite the sales of current leading smartphone grew double-digit due to the fall of Huawei and Honor. Above all, Realme, which only ranked 7th, was the fastest growing brand in the first quarter of 2021. The company's sales increased by whooping 451% and 82%. The company's sales incremented by a whooping percentage of 451% of year-on-year and 82% of quarter-to-quarter. Huawei has met the harsh pressure from the American authorities, effectively losing the ability to produce smartphones normally. Nevertheless, the Chinese electronic manufacturer continued to develop its own chipsets for the future. As you know, after the introduction of sanctions against Huawei by the United States, the Taiwanese TSMC was forced to abandon cooperation with the company, which produced a proprietary Kirin processor for Huawei smartphones developed by a subsidiary of the Chinese giant HiSilicon. Nevertheless, according to the latest data, Huawei Technologies filed an application for registration of the Kirin processor trademark on April 22. In the international classification, it belongs to the Category 9 scientific instruments. The company has probably not given up hope of returning to the market in the future. There have been incidents where WhatsApp users lost access to their accounts after they shared a 6-digit verification code received on the platform with someone claiming to be from the company. The company is reportedly working on the feature that aims to tackle such frauds. WhatsApp is working on a new feature called Flash Call that will allow users to automatically verify their phone number when they try to log into WhatsApp. Samsung Galaxy Watch 4 spotted on the Wi-Fi Alliance website. 13 models have been certified and Samsung Galaxy Watch 4 will run on Google's new Wear platform. Samsung Galaxy M52 5G reportedly in the works. The smartphone could launch as a rebranded Galaxy F52 5G. Samsung Galaxy M52 5G may launch in India to replace the Galaxy M51. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.